Hey, what's going on, Armaholics? So it's Maverick is back with another video. Today I'm going to show you the HLC AR-15 Rifle Series Pack. HLC has brought out a few weapon add-ons already for ARMA 3, but I'm just going to focus on the AR-15 pack in this video. I decided to choose the virtual reality environment again to record the footage, so the focus is really on the weapons and there's not a lot of environment distracting. The feedback I got on the last video was pretty good, so I'm going to continue for certain videos with this platform. To the topic at hand, the AR-15 rifle is probably something everybody has heard of already in real life. In this pack there's a few modifications. There's also somewhat of the standard issue versions, but some pretty cool modifications like the honey badger, as you see here. Those weapons are joint rail compatible, which means that you're going to be able to attach side rail attachments and side scopes and sometimes even silencers from the BIS selection, as well as other user-made content add-ons. For this add-on here, you do have a bunch of custom silencers, but no additional side rail attachments or sights and scopes. But the silencers included in the pack allow you to have custom weapon sounds for silenced as well as non-silenced firing. The pack also includes custom reload animations, as you can see right here, as well as a fire mode switch that actually moves on the model when you change the fire mode, which is for most of the rifles single fire as well as full auto, and for some of them also 3-round burst. I'm not going to show you each and every weapon individually. The next one here in the list is the AR-15.300 dissipator, somewhat of a standard issue assault rifle, pretty long barrel and a solid stock. So this is good for pretty much any combat scenario. But if you want to go close quarters, so in a tight environment, you want to bring something smaller, more compact, more light, especially with the newly integrated weapon sway and fatigue system in ARMA 3. So for fast and controlled movement in an urban environment, I advise to bring something smaller, more compact, like the AR-50 Magpul carbine or the AR-15 sanitized carbine. Both of those rifles are small, compact, and even with silencers, easy to handle within the building or generally urban environment, but obviously weaker on longer distances. My personal favorite is the BCM Czech carbine. First of all, it looks just cool, the sounds are great, and it is a decent assault rifle for CQC as well as medium range. So it's my go-to rifle when I'm expecting more conventional warfare in a mission. Also included are more standard versions of the AR-15, like the Bushmaster.300 carbine, the Colt carbine, or the Colt carbine with the grenade launcher. Somewhat unique and also very cool looking is the RRA LAR-15. This is a designated marksman rifle, as you can see, with a longer barrel, bipods attached, unfortunately not usable, so you cannot flip them down, and since there's still no official BIS weapon resting in the game, you cannot rest the weapon anywhere unless you use a particular user-made mod. Nevertheless, it looks very cool in my opinion. I like it a lot. Unfortunately, it's a 5.56 standard NATO round, so it's not that effective. About 2 headshots on an enemy who's wearing a helmet, about 3 or 5 chest shots to kill someone. This is just how the game works, unless, again, you use user-made content to modify the engine's behavior when it comes to weapon damage. Another nice feature of this pack is the fact that it comes with custom ammunition. So all the weapons use 5.56 NATO rounds, but there are a few modified versions like the EPR, the SOST, or the SPR rounds, or Stanag Max for those weapons. All of those rounds have a custom set of parameters, if you will. So the velocity is different, also the amount of damage they create on impact and things like that. As far as I can tell, without a lot of extended testing, is that the EPR rounds are the weakest and the SPR the strongest one. So I personally use those to make the 5.56 round a bit more effective in the vanilla game. Before I come to an end here, I want to show you one more feature. As you can see, while firing with this weapon, you can actually see how the bullets are like being pushed upwards in the magazine by spring. So this is an indication for you of how many rounds you got left. Also nice with those custom magazines in the pack is that the last 4 rounds in every magazine are tracers. So as soon as you see that you're starting to shoot tracers, it's definitely time to reload. This is definitely a nice and useful feature, and it's also realistic because most armies pack their magazines like that. So with those special features, I gotta say the overall quality of this mod is excellent, the visual detail on the models is great, plus the custom weapon sounds, animations and additional ammunition types are a great addition to the game. I totally recommend the HLZ weapon add-ons, especially the AR-15 pack as introduced in this video. Good stuff right there, and as always, free on armaholic.com for you to download. I hope the video was informative as well as entertaining. If it was, please give it a thumbs up, make sure to subscribe to Armaholic's official YouTube channel, and please check in on my private channel as well for more Arma 3 and other gaming content. My name is Swiss Maverick, and I see you next time.